So, Infinity War.
Arguably the worst MCU film to
Bro,
date.
what you mean? Everyone knows that a superhero story follows a really simple plot line. The heroes beat the villain.
But for some reason, what happened is in the film, there are literally 44 heroes and about 5 villains.
Okay, right about that. Also, 2.5 hours and they don't even win.
It was one person and his group of four goonies, well, three goonies, and how did you lose to them?
Look at this man, he's not even made of metal or something. He's just a large purple Josh Brolin.
You're telling me that Steve Rogers can physically almost stop Thanos with nothing but his bare hands, and you lost with 44 people.
Man, okay. So today we're asking the crucial question of how grape-flavored Joshy Boy was able to solo an entire planet.
Amethyst Joshua is an intergalactic warlord who likes putting knives on his hands for children to watch. He's out to wipe out 50% of the universal population in order to stop the rapid consumption of the infinite universe's finite resources. Because apparently no one on Earth or the depths of outer space is safe from
Okay, first off, weird plan. If you wipe out 50% of the universal population, it'll just repopulate again. Also, it's just a very damaging solution to a very significant problem. Second, Lavender Josh thought that if finite resources were a problem, why not just make more resources? It'll go away, just like the population will grow again. But at least you don't cause grief and horrible suffering across the entirety of material existence.
Either way, what happened to the rest of space itself is entirely irrelevant, considering that basically every single thing that heliotrope Josh needs to enact if his plan conveniently exists on the only important planet, Earth. Plum Josh needs the Infinity Stones.
He reads shows Infinity Stones. It's okay, he'll cut that out. He'll cut that out.
Five shiny rocks that were made during the Big Bang. That granted control over the one aspect of each one grants control over one aspect of the universe. Power, time, space, reality, mind, and soul. Except for some reason that doesn't make any sense. How the hell are those the six? Like what the hell is space? Like stone. What does it do? Anyways, conveniently enough, all of them except for power and reality just so happened to be on Earth, while the former were conveniently located in the same general location with the infinite vastness of space itself.
Alright, so now that reddish blue Josh has come to Earth to throw hands with the people half his size and feel so proud about it, we see the apocalypse begin to happen. We got some
Big
big
massive
massive.
space. Oh.
Yeah, we got some big massive spaceships, exactly like you said, that look like giant rings for no practical aesthetic or symbolic purpose to come down and collect these tiny rocks, which ironically are practically infinitesimal compared to the infinite size of the universe that they control. They cause huge massive panic, leading to masses of people booking it as far as they can away from the Death Donut.
In Wakanda, we can see a massive army of savage beasts that rip a people apart with claws and fangs that are capable of doomsdaying their way past the laser barrier, but not capable of surviving blunt force trauma and the power of American spirit.
Despite the fact that two cataclysmic events only happen in two countries of America and Africa, this is considered a worldwide threat that no other government, including the American government or the United Nations, had anything to say or do about it.
Either way, when Thor finally puts his friend's arm with a special knife taped to it through Amarthine's Josh giant purple text, it isn't enough because unfortunately that kind of injury doesn't actually kill people until the blade is taken out or something like that. By that time, he had already gotten all of his magic mood rocks and used them, manages to wipe out half the population of the universe with just the snap of his fingers.
Yeah, everywhere on the only planet that matters, Earth, you see the only important people, the superheroes, fading away without any sort of goodbye except for Peter Parker,
I don't
because
have
we
it. I
need to
don't
feel
have
sadder
it.
about him more than everybody else. Miraculously, 50% of the human population was wiped out, which, again, really impressive considering what Thanos wiped was universal population, which had to be beyond the numbers we can actually count. So to think that only about 4.5 billion human beings were wiped out is a lot better than anyone would have expected, if you think about it, right?
But that's bad at the end of the day, because again, Earth is the only planet that matters, and so the human species is the only species that matters. And so losing half the people of the worldwide, half the people in the worldwide is travesty. Friends, family, loved ones all vanish without a second thought or a moment to process what even happened. The entire world is set into massive panic and economic collapse across the entire planet, which would realistically crash and burn, putting the entire normal human civilization that did survive in utter chaos. In a singular moment of magenta Josh Brolin's hands, the world as we knew it came to an end. And again, it's Josh Brolin's fault.
Ultimately, this is the story of the end of the world, which makes it bad because I don't want it to happen while I'm still alive. In every sense of the word, this is an apocalyptic moment and a harrowing reminder that human capitalism is what will drive us disaster. Because at the end of the day, it isn't going to be aliens that come and kill us all.
I mean, it might. We don't know. We might piss off some aliens and get wiped out. Who knows?
But what's probably more likely is that we are the real enemies of the story, and it is in our hubris, our arrogance, our natural greed that exists among us that we see our worlds crumble before us. So, tune in for the next video about Avengers Endgame coming in exactly 1 year, because if you want to banger summaries like this one, you're going to have to wait and, like, we all had to wait for Endgame to come out to see how that story ended. Like, comment, and subscribe, guys. See you later. Peace.